If it's knowledge you seek, we've told you.
Paul said it was an army of a cash.
Through Orcish lands.
I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Here's everything we've received and everything promised. You earned this. All done? Clive. My dad had it all worked out.
He'd be proud of you, Mid. His writings may have helped, but this achievement is all yours. Can we catch them?
The Einar's one of the largest, fastest vessels ever built. And it won't help she has the wind at her back. Any other ship would be hard-pressed to keep pace with her, let alone reel her in. But this isn't any other ship. This is the Enterprise! And the world's never seen anything like my dad's engine.
It certainly hasn't.
Clive, what do you know of Barnabas Tharm?
Only what the bards sing. That he sailed to Ash from southern lands. That it was his mastery of the blade which won him the throne. And that his sword, Odin's sword, can sever the very threads of creation. But don't lose any sleep over a last tilt. We'll do what we must to survive.
What we must.
The light! I thought this cove was meant to be hidden!
Mid! Company!
Eh?
We'll hold them off until the ship is ready! But hurry!
Bollocks! All hands! Man your stations!
Everyone with me? Here they come!
Yeah.
enough!
That was easy enough.
All right, you lousy lot. Get your asses on board. She's ready to sail.
You heard the captain. Clive.
Confound it. Then it is as I feared. Sleipnir is no man, but a creation of Odin.
Phoenix's fiery fundament! Have you no normal enemies?
For another round?
Of course we are. Right, Lord Rosfield?
My boy, there was a time people called me the Executioner.
Or was it my eyes?
No matter, heads will roll all the same.
Mate, new plan! You leave, we follow!
Follow? Swimming, are you? Oh, bugger me! Weigh anchor! Engines dead slow ahead!
Have care, my friends. It is not blood that runs through Omegi's veins. These foes will not fall easily.
But they will fall.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe.
Good thing I brought one!
How long are we meant to keep this up?
As long as it takes. Unless you have a better idea.
Well, I've already killed at least 5 of the bastards.
Fuck it. Let's do the lot.
Thank you.
do you want?
That's quite a mess you've made. And wholly unnecessary. You are my offering to Muthos. I would not see you damaged.
Now back to your stations! Every bell spent treading water puts another league between us and the galleon.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine. Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Randalar can provide them. Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back. Cheerio! Oh, yeah. Keep up, my boy.
Well, we can't have him showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it. What have I done?
My lord.
Thank you.
between here and Walud. But any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take them forever and a fortnight to reach Stonehere.
Mid knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I say we do as she tells.
Sails on the horizon.
She's ours. Look alive, boys! Pull ahead! And keep those furnaces fed!
Aye, aye!
Do you feel that,
Jill?
All hands! Battle stations! Let's see what this girl can do.
Where one leads, so does the other follow. The bond of consciousness which joins them condemning both to the same fate. Yet my every attempt to strike it from their hearts serves only to tighten its hold. Fascinating. There is naught my blade cannot sever.
Bloody hell! Had a starboard!
gets him alive!
Hold on. I'm coming. For both of you.
Get back!
How did you...
I'll explain later. Hands. Can you walk?
Out of here I can.
Stand still!
Phoenix. Are you not the dominant of fire? I see naught before me but a guttering flame.
To where?
You... What did you do to Joshua?
Phoenix? Oh, I expect he will survive. This consciousness in which you coil your feeble souls is grown thick with desperation. And thus has my master turned to my blade. The world will soon be painted in black. And all that live shall gather in death's autumn wake.
Not if we remove the cause of this misery. Not if we destroy the last of the Mother Crystals and restore balance to the world.
Come, do you truly think it's so simple? The blight is inevitable. Not even the Almighty might stop its endless march. Your efforts will avail us naught. Naught, that is, but suffering. You must embrace the truth, Mythos. Accept your place with the Lord.
Keep it. As long as there's a chance, there's a choice.
Thank you.
ever led astray by your blind resolve. It is time you learn the inevitability of your divine fate, however much it may hurt.
Get as far away as you can.
Clive, no!
Trust me, Jill.
You down, dragging you ever further from your purpose.
And what is my purpose?
Mythos. Who are we? What are the dominants? The breath of the Creator still warm on our lips. We carry his light that we might guide the masses in his name. We are but mighty acts of God.
We are more than that.
You would be nothing without what he has granted you. The power we wield is his, and yet every time we draw upon it, it wears away at our very being. It breaks us. It unmakes us, that its immaculate aspect might reveal itself. The Icon. It is too much for even his chosen few. apart from you, Muthos. You wield the might of many, yet your body does not answer for its avarice.
What are you saying?
What I am saying is that we dominants are a means to an end. We were created for you, that you might drink deep of our strength and thereby fulfill your divine purpose.
Which is?
To feed. As you would know, could you only look beyond the walls of your prison of self-regard. As long as you choose to ignore this, you shall never penetrate my defenses. Still, you may take solace in the fact that you are not alone in your plight. The chains of volition shackle all of mankind, but there is yet cause to rejoice. For the Lord, in his mercy, has taken pity on his flawed creations, and shall see them restored to their proper forms.
And what exactly would that be?
Why, loyal servants to God.
No.
Manners, Lord Rossfield? They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
You mean to turn everyone Akashic?
Not turn, Muthos. Turn back. For too long has mankind been led astray by their clamorous wills. It is time they return to a world of quiet equality, where they might once more know salvation.
Salvation? And abandon everything we hold dear?
We don't need your salvation. We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it on our own terms. Not yours, and not your gods.
With every defiant expression of your will, the tighter the chains of consciousness become. But perhaps that fact may be put to use. The faster it binds you to the remaining dominance, the stronger your hunger will become. Until it leads you back to the only answer there ever was. Mayhap not by the path my master intended, but back all the same.
Ash is not far. I could freeze a path.
You're in no fit state.
Probably not, but I can try. Don't look back! The others are safe.
The Enterprise was clear of the gap when we fell. They made it, Jill. And they will have seen the ice where it led. We need only wait till dawn. This is the second time Barnabas has bested me. I'm powerless against him.
Then maybe there really is nothing else for it but to give yourself to his master. Only you won't do that. The Clive I know would never do that.
So you believe? But do you really know me? If what Barnabas said was true, then I'm more monster than man. And each time I summon the flames from within, I burn away the things that make me who I am.
Do you, though? Think of what you've used that power for. Of all the people you've saved. It doesn't matter how or by whom it was granted, only how you choose to use it. And you've chosen to use it for good, haven't you?
I've also used it to kill. What if that's my purpose? What if it's all I'm good for?
You're still that same boy I grew up with. Always so eager to save everyone around you, and yet always so low. Because you failed to realize the one thing that needed saving most of all. You, Clive. You. You never once took the time to save yourself.
Myself. I think I might be beyond saving.
No one is beyond saving, provided they want to be saved. You fight to survive. And you survive so that you may protect those you love. It's what you do. What you've always done. And I know you're not about to change. So I'm going to help you. To give you what you need to protect us all.
Jill. Are you sure? If this is what you want, then...
give you the strength to bear it alone.
But I'm not alone. These burdens I carry, my sins, my pain, my sorrow, I see now that they are all a part of me. And I will gladly bear your burdens too, until my last breath.
Clive.
I promise you, Jill. We will find a way to escape this fate. Find a way to save each other. That we might one day look upon the moon again, together.
And I promise you, Clive, that I will be there, no matter what you must become.
I know. I never thought a smile could bring me so much joy.
What of Barnabas? Do we pursue him?
No. Our paths will cross again soon enough, whether we like it or not. Besides, there is something we must do first.
Of course. Drake's spine. The last mother crystal.
The Einherjar is at the bottom of the sea. Walud won't dare move on Storm without her. But they know we're coming now. We'll need a plan. And a damn good one at that.
Then let's go home and find one. Ash will have to wait.
Mid says Odin split the sea in two. She's always been partial to a tall tale. But there's tall, and then there's tall.
I struggle to believe it myself.
I see your uncle isn't with you.
He stayed with the Enterprise. After our brush with the Einherjar, she was in urgent need of repair. And my uncle knows a shipwright in Randalar. We're to join him there when we're ready to sail for Ash.
You sure that's wise? Last I heard, the place was still overrun with a Kashyyyk.
Show me a city where that isn't true. Ultima's plague is spreading.
We're running out of time, aren't we? We've done our best to shore up the hideaway. But I doubt a few planks will stop what's coming. Still, we'll keep at it. Every little helps, I suppose.
Let's hope so. Joshua. Assuming Tanya will allow it.
You need anything? You just ask. We might not have your uncle's resources, but resourcefulness, we've got in spades.
Again? What is it that you wish to learn? Study it well, Clive. One must understand one's place in the world. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
How do you split the sea, you reckon?
I reckon we're better off not knowing.
You need anything, you just ask. We might not have your uncle's resources, but resourceful enough.
Then again, why settle for low-born chaff when we've honest-to-goodness royalty right here beneath our roof? If Prince Dion cannot see my love for him, then perhaps the Phoenix will.
Welcome home, Cid.
So, she don't need sails or oars, but she's still the fastest ship on the sea?
That's what Mid says, anyway. Though I'd have to see it to believe it.
The last king, on account of the fact he hasn't aged a day since claiming the throne.
But that was almost 35 years ago.
Ah, Cid. I saw Mid and the others made it back in one piece. More or less. Would that the free cities had fared so well. It will take years to rebuild what was lost to His Majesty's Akashic Army.
Mm.
How was she? The Enterprise, I mean.
With Canva in the hands of a Kashyyyk, we'll need to find another port. Preferably one as well hidden as the Ironworks.
Ah, Cid. Just the man I was hoping to see. Did you have a mo?
Don't tell me. You need more bomb ash.
Oh, no. We still got plenty of that left. I'm working on bringing another one of Lachiche's designs to life. This time, it's a new smelter. It's got a reverberatory hood over the top for additional thermo amplification and a system of reciprocal recirculatory regenerators that. Let's just say it gets very blimmin' hot. A heck of a lot hotter than anything Blackthorn's got in his forge, that's for certain. Only mithril engines get hotter, and you can't chuck ore in one of them and get metal out the other end. Trouble is, we won't be able to make out of any old rubbish neither. We need the good stuff. And I hear you once helped Helena get her hands on exactly that. Any chance you could help me too?
If it's for the good of the hideaway, I'd be happy to.
Oh, it is. I promise you.
So, what exactly is this good stuff you need me to find?
We've got a couple of examples here. Spherical echoes, we call them.
Or fallen materials. So this smelter is similar to the mithril engine in more ways than one.
That's right. They're a bit like the thermal helms. Fallen ceramics deal with heat like nothing else, see? And what's more, they're directional, transferring heat from the inside to the outside. But these things, they're all outside. If we line the hood with them, they'll reflect the heat right back into the furnace. We've collected as many as we can, and I know where we can get the rest. Trouble is, they're all watched over by their bigger, uglier cousins.
So you want me to visit some ruins, destroy some echoes, and bring back the spheres they're guarding?
That's it in a nutshell, yeah. We're only 3 short, mind. And we know exactly where they are. There's one up Amberway, in that ruin that they call Lost Plume, and another in the Silent South, over in Dalmechia. Last one is in the ruins of Advent, which is in the Empire.
All right, then. Wish me luck.
It'll do. I'll be keeping all my fingers and toes crossed. Can't say I've ever been to the Silent Sound myself. Nor Advent, for that matter. I've hardly ever been out of the Duchy, to tell you the truth. Did get the chance to visit Lost Plume once, though. What a piece of work that place is. Would have stuck around to study the relics more. If half of them hadn't been trying to blimmin' kill me.
How was she?
Miss, can we read Miss Editor's story for our lesson today?
What a wonderful idea, Jocelyn. Let's do just that.
Finished the book I was writing. You're welcome to read it, if young Jocelyn hasn't already defiled its pages with his infernal scribblings.
Molly's lemon tarts.
I've never had anything so delicious.
I should be so lucky. They're all in Tet's belly before they've even had time to cool.
Oh! Oh, what is it? Be seeing ya.
If I painted you black, could you fly me across the lake? Are you even listening?
Lady Karen's called in a favor with one of her suppliers. We should have a new shipment of sackcloth before the next moon.
Not a moment too soon.
These and the Deadlands will seem less dead.
These flowers are beautiful. Pity we have to boil them all down to make medicine.
A trader from across the sea once told me that on the continent they...
Farmers are abandoning their fields and traders their routes. Most of what we have now comes from here in the Idaway.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Hope adrift on foam-flecked peaks. Despair.
Little people.
Hush you. That man doesn't owe you anything.
What do you recommend?
A shirt. This is a tavern, not a brothel. Running out of things to boil in the brown. Wonder if anyone would notice if I slipped a boot in.
Clive.
If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that.
Finished, are you?
Trouble with your gear, or the Sanctfornian, do you? Not bad, if I do say so myself.
Forget this kindness, my lord. I shall go to Eastport. But as soon as the rebuilding work is complete... There's no way of knowing if Doris will confide in me. But I can speak to her at least.
Have a resilience to the ill effects of ether.
Sid, did you know that chocobos are far more resilient to the effects of ether than the most of...
Good morrow to you, my friend.
I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. Always welcome, Clive.
Mid said I could ride the Enterprise next.
No, she didn't. She said I could.
Sid made it home safely.
His brother didn't look all that well, though. Find me some, or I'm taking a saw to your bed. Skies?
Don't bother me.
Though I reckon it'd be a different story if my skiff had wings.
And lumps, the lot of them. It's a wonder they can still walk.
It's a wonder they made it back at all. I heard Odin was there.
I suppose you've got quite the tale to tell. But I'll let you get some nice warm stew in you first, before I go bothering you for the details.
You said?
I'm looking for Doris. Is she here?
I'm afraid not. She's at Martha's Rest on a job. My job, actually. When she heard what the mission was, she insisted on going herself. Alone.
Did she? What was the mission?
Following up on some new information. Once they'd settled in, the bearers you helped liberate in the Dragon's Eyrie were keen to talk about their imprisonment. And about their captor.
The slaver Cole's team were tracking when they were attacked by the Beastmen. I'll go and find her. She's at Martha's Rest, you say?
If she's not moved on already, yes. I hope everything's all right.
Why would Doris insist on going alone? Maybe Cole was right to be worried.
I would have gone to Martha's Rest with Doris, but she ordered me to stay behind. And I'm not about to start disobeying orders.
Heard the bad news then, did you?
What bad news?
About Dravosht. Blackthorn's old haunt. With the forge and all that. Well, anyway, the mines just down the road from there are spewing out ether like no one's business.
And the village?
Safe from the flood for now, but they've got other problems. Akashic. Every creature in the area is either turned or on the way to turning, apparently. Zoltan and the others are living on borrowed time. They need help, and quick. Doris sent a few curse breakers to keep an eye on things, but there's only so much a couple of scouts can do. Except get eaten. If something ain't done soon, the old place will be overrun.
I won't let that happen.
Didn't think you would.
Does Blackthorn know?
I thought it might be better if he didn't. He'd only do something stupid. You reckon we should tell him?
No. It's better this way.
Yeah, well, I can't stand about knowing what's happening out there, so I'm off. I'll see you in Dravosht.
Joshua.
Better than I was.
But not nearly as well as you should be. Your cuts and burns may have healed, but your body still bears the burden of every spell cast.
And what would you have had me do? It was no ordinary foe we faced. It was the Warden of Darkness. Yet still, it was not enough. The King could have ended me at any moment, but instead chose to toy with me like a curl does a mouse.
You underestimate yourself.
Oh, it was crystal clear. Only one man established his dominance that day, and that man was Barnabas. I'm sorry, brother. That was ill-spoken. It's just, I have never felt so powerless. And when so many are looking to us for strength, perhaps Perhaps the prince feels the same.
What is this place?
Don't move. It's fresh from the well. Grandmother told me spirits sometimes get lost, and that the lanterns guide them to their proper place. I set one on the river for her when she passed away.
Was it you who guided my hand then, Ultima? No, not you. This is my doing, my fault, my sin to bear. And for it, I must atone.
Your hurts are healing nicely. It was my poultices that saw you well.
You make them.
And sell them, or try to. Earns me enough for bread, most days.
Forgive me. I have nothing to...
I know, but I couldn't just leave you lying there. You're going then?
Of course. I'm healed. Thanks to you and your poultices.
Will you promise to come back and visit?
Phoenix, it would seem that I owe you my wings.
Perhaps he can find an answer. You will be returning to Walud soon, I gather.
I see no reason to wait.
Then neither do I.
I can think of a few, but I doubt they'll stop you. You will take your medicine.
Of course, Lady Dire.
Set on leaving already, are you?
How long will it take us to get back to Ash?
Dunno, about the same amount of time it took us to get here. Maybe less, if your uncle can find someone trustworthy to patch up the Enterprise. All depends on where we're putting into port, mind.
Yes. It's not as if we can put ashore wherever we choose. We have to assume that the whole of Ash is hostile, and that we'll be attacked on sight.
Then we must find a place they won't think to look. And I have an idea who might know of one.
The Professor! I'll go and tell you, come in!
While you're plotting our course, I'll be in the shelves with your lawsman. I wish to pick his brains about Ultima.
Then I'll talk to Karen about supplies for the journey. They may not be easy to come by in Ash.
Your brother's body won't take much more of this recklessness. You know that, don't you?
I do.
You've seen more of the world these past 5 years than most do in a lifetime. It's a shame you never had a moment to enjoy it.
You need anything, you just ask. We might not have you.
Say it all you like. It doesn't make it true.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them.
Come back.
Run out of Papio nuts and all.
The stew's
So this is our new home, is it?
First things first, we'll need to get a few of these roofs seen to. Wouldn't want to be caught in a storm without any shelter.
Doris should be somewhere nearby. Assuming she's still here.
Ah, Clive. I was just about to send for you. I'd like you to take something to Sir Wade up in Eastpool. Seeds for planting. Thought it was about time they started growing their own food. I'll keep providing them with whatever they need in the meantime, of course. But if Eastpool's going to survive, it's got to be able to fend for itself. As have those poor bearers. They've lived their whole lives in servitude, but now they're their own masters. Small wonder they ain't got the foggiest how to provide for themselves. So it's up to us to teach them. And if you're wondering why you, well, the wagoneers taking supplies up that way have been coming back with more and more reports of a Kashyyyk around the village of late. Sir Wade's putting a brave face on it, but I think even he's starting to worry. And if he's likely to share those concerns with anyone, it's you.
All right.
Thanks. Wouldn't ask if I didn't have to. There. That should be enough to keep him in Ghazal Greens for a few years at least.
Ghazal Greens?
Not the most mouth-watering crop, I'll admit. But they're hardy, they grow fast, and they fill a hole. Better that than something that'll wither away at first frost. And chocobos love them too, which is no small thing. When I say all of us need to pull together to get Eastpool back on its feet, I mean all of us. They ain't exactly succulent, but cook 'em right and they're just about bearable.
I'll take your word for it.
Anyway, Sir Wade'll know what to do with them. And if he don't, well, I'll go up there and show him myself.
I'm sure you will.
Get them Ghazal green seeds up to Sir Wade in Eastpool, would you? And while you're there, ask him what the situation is with the Akashic over that way. He might actually tell you the truth.
Just because the heavens have gone to wreck and ruin, it don't mean we have to.
Nearly done.
I've got greens of all shapes and sizes. Colours too. Mostly green though.
Looking for shelter, are you?
How do? Take care out there, eh?
The world seems to be changing so fast lately I can hardly keep up. But what I do know is that there's more bad news than good. You can tell that just by looking at people's faces.
It doesn't still hurt, does it?
Oh, 1,000 Akashic jaws couldn't hurt me. I'm a son of Rosaria, after all. A born survivor.
It's been a pleasure, Doris. Just like old times.
I'll give your offer some thought, my lady.
How goes the investigation?
Sid, what brings you to Martha's Rest?
You. I heard you were out here on your own, tracking our slaver. I trust you're being careful.
Of course. And it had to be me. The bearers from the Dragon's Eyrie confirmed a long-held suspicion of mine that the slaver we've been tracking is an old acquaintance. She's no fool. If we'd come in force, she would have spotted us straight away, and then vanished without a trace.
That was her just now, wasn't it? So, was it a fruitful reunion?
I'd say so. She tried to recruit me. Seems her time in Rosaria is coming to an end. She's abducted bearers from across the region and is looking to smuggle them back into Sambrek. After her brush with those beastmen on the road to Northreach, she hired herself an Imperial escort, which she wants me to join. She's dangerous, Sid, but I think I can stop her.
Then I'm going with you. I'll take care of the escort. You can see the bearers to safety. Where are they?
The Baum Arches, soon to break camp. You go on ahead. I'll follow once I've sent word back to the hideaway. She asked me to join her at the Baum Arches. It's a wonder she still trusts me after everything that happened.
Ah, Lord Rossfield. What brings you to Eastpool?
A delivery from Martha.
These are Gizal green seeds. Martha's keen to cut the apron strings, then, is she? I jest, of course. You see, I had thought we might be able to revive the old wheat fields. But they'd long since gone to seed, only without the seeds.
Martha was hoping he might be able to show the bearers how to plant and tend these, so that they'll be able to fend for themselves.
That's not a bad idea. These bearers had only recently escaped their bonds before we brought them here. They know little of freedom, of providing for themselves and their loved ones. Unless we teach them how to live like free men, I fear that all we have achieved in bringing them here is to exchange one master for another. Not that myself and the Guardians have been the best example to them so far, subsisting almost entirely on Martha's charity as we do. It's about time we all started to provide for ourselves, bearers and Guardians alike. Unfortunately, we've been a little too busy of late to focus on much besides bolstering our defenses. There have been alarming reports of...
The Horde is closing in. They're coming, so wait, all of them.
Time it all. I thought we'd have more time. Gather the men in the square. Send to the rest for reinforcements.
Yes, Sir Wade.
The Horde.
A Kashyyyk, a veritable legion of them. They've been seen prowling around the northern reaches for a while now. We don't have the numbers to hold back a swarm that size. I had hoped to build a perimeter wall so that myself and the Guardians might be able to defend the village, but...
Now you're out of time.
Precisely. If reinforcements from the rest arrive before they do, we may just scrape through, but I fear that's rather an enormous if.
What if you could call on reinforcements from Eastpool?
You mean the bearers? We brought them here so they might live, not die, fighting for their lives.
So wait... You said you lack men to defend the village. Are the bearers not men? Do they not wish to see Eastpool saved? Though they may not be trained soldiers like your Guardians, what help they are able to offer could still prove the difference between victory and defeat.
You're right, my lord. I will appeal to them. My friends, I humbly beg your aid. We Guardians are few and our enemies many. But I swear we can defeat them with you at our side.
You would send us to the slaughter. To serve as bait for those fiends so that you and your men might be spared. And to think... We trusted you. Say what you will. A home is not worth dying for.
But it is worth fighting for. Sir Wade fights to give you lot a chance. Just like I do. Just like Sid does. We all wanted to give you a home where you could be free. And you got one, didn't you? This place, Eastpool.
This is your village. Your home. And if you don't fight to protect what's yours, you'll lose it. You know I'm right. This world wants to take everything from you. Everything. Your homes, your freedom, your very lives. So then, are you going to stand by and let that happen to you? Are you going to accept fate like good little Bran did and die, having never stood up for yourselves? Or will you fight like free men and women?
Give me a sword. I never dreamt I'd have a home of my own. And now that I have, I don't want to lose it. I will protect what's mine, or die trying.
We all will. Free men and women, fighting together. For Eastpool!
For Eastpool!
Thank you, Martha.
Don't mention it. Just promise me one thing, that you'll show them how freeborn fight.
Gladly.
Well, if it was numbers you were lacking, you certainly won't be now.
Thanks to you.
Me? Oh, I just love the sound of my own voice.
Lord Rossfield, my lady, we're ready.
So what's the plan of action?
We'll divide our forces into several small detachments, each made up of guardians, bearers, and guards from the rest. These will position themselves at strategic points around the village. Upon engaging with the Akashic, each detachment will keep the creatures occupied as best they can, steadily retreating all the while.
You're going to lure them into the village?
I am. We will have neither the time nor the resources to treat the wounded, so injuries must be avoided at all costs. Instead, we will focus purely on defense at first. By coordinating our withdrawal through the use of messengers drawn from among the bearers, we will aim to have the swarm converge at a point of our choosing. With luck, that point will be the village square. The perfect place for our most able warriors to surround them and fall upon them. And for you and I to finish them off.
A sound plan, but one that'll require a leader with a cool head and strong nerves to coordinate the retreat. I'd say you have both in abundance await, but you'll be needed. Please, leave the last of the fighting to me.
Ha! And let you have all the glory. Sir, wait! They're here!
Then you know what you must do. We work together, everyone playing their part, each shielding the other that no man might fall, that Eastpool might live on. For Rosaria!
For Rosaria!
We've no time to argue, my lord. I'll do as you ask.
And I will do as you ask.
Suppose we'd better do our bit too, then, eh?
Right you are, Martha.
The calm before the storm. Here it comes. I will not let this village fall.
To me, boy!
Looks like that's the last of them.
Lord Rushfield! Change of plan!
What is it?
Owl from the rest. An Akashic Curl's been sighted on Rhiannon's ride and is headed in their direction.
Well, the better half of her guard is here. So wait, how many Akashic remain in East Pool?
Hard to say. My men are still facing some resistance, but I think the worst is behind us. I could order a detachment or two to fall back and...
No. Let them finish the job. You stay here too, Sir Wade. Your men need you. I'll go after the Curl. Join me only when East Pool is won.
If you're sure, my lord. May the Founder protect you.
Tell me an Akashic Curl's heading towards the rest. Get yourself down there. We can handle things here.
Next one's mine. I might not know one end of a sword from the other, but I can roast the bastards.
All right.
The Curl was sighted on Rhiannon's ride back towards Martha's Rest. Founder, speed you, my lord.
East Pool will be safe in our hands, my lord. You have my word.
Get him!
It's over.
All right. Back to Eastpool.
Lord Rossfield, the Curl, is it?
It's dead.
Thank the Founder for that. And for you, my lord. We were able to eradicate the rest of the Horde. I have guardians posted around the village to keep watch for further attacks, but all seems quiet for now. I hesitate to say it, but I think it might be over.
I think it might.
We did it. We saved Eastpool. Thank you, my friends. Thank you.
No, Sir Wade. It's us who should be thanking you. You brought us together. Showed us what it means to fight for what you hold dear.
We never had nothing to call our own before. We didn't know what it meant to protect it. But now we do. We really do.
Forgive us, Sir Wade. You and your people saved us. And still we doubted you. But there's no doubt in my mind anymore. We're free men now. So we have to start acting like it. We have to fight to protect what's ours. To protect Eastpool.
And we shall. We all shall. Together. This is our home. And if anyone or anything tries to take it away,
they'll have us to answer to.
Come on, then. Let's get to work.
This village isn't going to rebuild itself.
They're not slaves anymore.
No. They're Osarians. Your father took pity on the bearer's plight, and I believe if he were still with us today, this is what he would have wanted.
I believe you might be right.
I shall remain here, my lord, and do what I can to help rebuild the village. After all, this is my home now too, and I could hardly call myself an Eastpoolian if I didn't pull my weight.
I think you'll find it's Eastpoolian, Sir Wade. But you should be proud, all the same. I'll have to pull my weight, too. Can't have the rest getting outclassed. Speaking of which, I ought to be getting back.
Can we continue to count on your support, Martha?
Of course. And I'd be counting on yours, too. Us Rosarians have got to stick together, haven't we?
Indeed we have.
And Clive, come by the Golden Stables when you get the chance. I ain't paid you for delivering them seeds yet.
All right. I will.
Lord Rossfield, do you remember our very first mission together? Clearing the goblins from the Stillwind Marshes?
How could I forget?
There's one sight that I shall never forget. You. Facing off against that giant Morble. Not a trace of fear on your face. Since that day, there have been more than a few times when I felt like giving up. When the odds seemed so stacked in the enemy's favor, I thought I may as well just lay down my sword and surrender. But every time, I would think back to the look in your eyes that day and remember what it means to be a shield. Know that whatever trials Eastpool may face, I shall never lose courage. Thanks to you.
Sir Wade, you have always been a true shield. I know that Eastpool, and indeed all of Rosaria, will be safe in your hands.
Thank you, my lord.
I know the rest of the world will be safe in yours.
I'll do my best.
Thank you again for all you have done for me and mine, my lord. You may rest assured that Eastpool will be safe in my hands. Thanks to you.
We couldn't have done this if we hadn't all pulled together. Even you and Martha chipped in. We owe you a debt of gratitude, my lord.
We defended Eastpool once. We can do it again. And again! And again!
Thank you, my lord. You showed us what it means to fight for what's ours. And we shall strive to follow in your footsteps.
The hero returns. It's lucky you came by when you did, eh? Not only did my seeds get delivered, but you went and saved Eastpool and all.
I just did what I could.
And it's only right that you get rewarded for it. Take it before I change my mind.
Thank you, Martha.
So, Eastpool's finally back on its feet again. And a home to free bearers. Who'd have thought we'd see the day, eh?
Well, it was your idea.
I know that, but I never stopped to think what it would mean. Bearers in charge of themselves, thinking for themselves, working for themselves. Like your hideaway, but not even hidden away. Though I suppose the rest ain't much different nowadays. You know, bearers living free like that reminds me of when I first met Sid. Loath as I am to recall that particular day.
I take it you didn't always see eye to eye. What happened?
Well, if you really want to know, I started doing what I do long before I met Sid. In fact, that's how I met him. Or at least how he came to meet me. He showed up at the stables one day, asking questions about who'd been buying up bearers. Founder knows what he thought I was doing with them. Running a hunt, poking around in their innards. Something awful anyway. Me, I thought he was a new constable. Thought the game was up. But somehow we both managed to work out what each other was about. And before I knew it, the cheeky arse was rattling on at me about how I was doing it all wrong. After all my hard work. Told me I was giving them relief, but not freedom. That my bearers were still dying as slaves. Got right under my skin, it did. Told him if he didn't like it, he could bugger off and report me to the garrison. And do you know what he did? He smiled, and then he laughed. And then I did the same. We made a pact that day. That whenever one of us was in need, the other would always be there for him.
And you were?
Well, we both wanted the same thing. To make life better for bearers. Just like your dad. Do you know, I was born right around the time Elwyn became Archduke. Growing up, I saw how he tried to change things. He certainly didn't lack for ambition, that one.
Indeed. But the loftier one's ambitions, the harder they are to achieve. Which is why those of us who follow in their footsteps need to finish what people like Sid and my father started.
Suppose you're right, aye. And if we don't manage it, there's always them who come after us. Good thing we've got a few half-decent sorts waiting in the wings, eh? It's almost enough to give you a little bit of hope.
Just a little.
Anyway, enough nattering. Better get back to work. Let's see about making everyone some dinner, shall we? The least the folks who saved Eastpool deserve is a hot meal. And you and me ain't gonna save the world on an empty stomach neither.
That sounds like a wonderful idea.
Don't worry, Clive. You went alone in this fight. Whenever you find yourself in need, be it of money, men, or a bowl of hot stew, the stable's door is always open.
Can't say it wasn't a relief to see the better part of the Guardians finally taking their leave. We barely had room to breathe, what with them and us and all the others all crammed in together.
Yet. How did Doris come to know a slaver, I wonder?
We've waited long enough. She's not coming. Ready the bearers. We're leaving.
Back to civilization, is it, Mom?
With all haste, lest any of you lackwits start talking like these feckless bumpkins. I presume your men are ready. We've suffered too many delays as it is. Any more, and I'll be docking your pay.
Yes, Mom.
Oh, but before you go, it appears we have company. Kill him.
You're welcome to try.
Wind!
So much for your escort.
You'll forgive me for not avenging my men. I'm not the swordswoman I used to be. I surrender. Do with me as you wish, Cid the Outlaw.
Cid!
Ah, Doris. I take it you're not here to rescue me from our brooding renegade. You know, I always wondered where you'd vanished to. But casting your lot with this criminal of all people.
Better fighting for a cause than killing for coin. I'm sorry, Cid. I should have told you sooner. This woman, my former master, once trained bearer children to be weapons in service of the highest bidder. She raised me like a daughter, and I did terrible things to earn her favor.
It wasn't all terrible, surely. We had our fun, too. You were always so eager to learn, and had such clever hands. All my other children took either to the blade or to the books. Always either or. But you proved yourself a master of both. That's why I kept you for my own. How about it, my little dagger? Care to swear that blade to me again?
I never swore my blade to you, nor will I ever. I fight for a higher cause. To liberate the bearers of this world. Farewell, master. Thank you for making me the weapon I am.
You always were a righteous child. Perhaps that's the reason I loved you so.
What do you want to do with her?
I am not the killer she wanted me to be. Not anymore. And she no longer has friends in high places. The dame does, though. Her connections at the Imperial Court will see that justice is done.
All right. If you're certain.
I am. And thank you for everything. Now, I better let these bearers know that they're safe.
I should head back to the hideaway and put Cole's mind at ease.
Welcome back, Cid. Doris's message just arrived. I hear you saved more bearers from being smuggled across the border.
With any luck, they'll be joining us in the hideaway shortly. Oh, and your letter. You don't need to worry about Doris anymore.
I'd been hoping as much. She mentioned one or two things in her report. So the slaver we'd been chasing all these months was her former master. Wish I'd known. She's been arrested, by the way, over in Sambrek. Went quietly, or so we're told. And she won't be getting off lightly. The Empire may have no love for bearers, but it's none too fond of black market traders either. Can't have been easy for Doris.
I'm sure it wasn't. But don't worry. She'll be all right.
I hope so. Suppose you should know, eh? You had quite the pass yourself before you came here, or so I understand. Anyway, thanks again, Cid. The Cursebreakers would be lost without Doris. And you, of course.
Keep up the good work, Cole.
Karen says she'll provide what she can for our voyage to Ash, and has even agreed to forgo payment. Until our return, that is.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them.
Come back.
come on.
Run like the wind.
Time to fight.
Be safe.
Get him! This one!
it. Right then. Just two more to find.
August waiting for you inside. Well, go on then.
So Dravosht is still standing. For now at least.
If you can swing a hammer, you can swing a sword.
I never thought I'd have to.
But I want to go with you.
And I want you to stay here and look after your mother.
We've spread the word. Those who can't fight are taking refuge inside their houses.
Good. Then let's get the tools out.
Promise you'll come back to me. Don't you dare leave me alone.
I promise, all right? Now stay indoors and stay quiet.
Anyone without a blade, come and get one. Edge in Dravosht, guaranteed.
The brass neck of that girl. Everyone's coming together to fight for their lives, and she hasn't lowered her prices a gill.
I have some things for sale. Go safely now.
Sid, good to see you. Our scouts are keeping watch on the edges of the Aether Flood. Any movement, you'll be the first to know.
Clive! You're here!
And the Akashic?
Mostly off to the north still. But I spoke to Doris' scouts and it turns out things are worse than I thought. There's swarms of them out there. Told old Snotty to be ready to seal the north gate. That should buy us some time if we need it. Enough for the villagers to barricade themselves inside their homes, at least.
Well done.
Welcome back, Sid. I'd never have guessed, you know. Not if August hadn't let slip. Who'd have thought that the savior of Dravosht would turn out to be the realm's most infamous outlaw? Keen to help us out again?
I am.
Thought you could sneak off without me, did ya?
Blackthorn.
Oh, what are you doing here?
One of the scouts couldn't keep his voice down. Unlike my best mate who didn't think I deserved to know. Zoldan, how long's it been? Long enough for us two to turn into a pair of old codgers, I see.
Then your idea of an apology. Prick.
Don't listen to him. You only did what you thought was best. For the village and that.
I did, yeah. But that ain't the whole of it. Vulcan, our master, didn't leave the chieftain to the two of us. He left it to me. The best blacksmith in Dravosht, barring himself, of course. Bloody stupid tradition, in my opinion. If someone's got talent, you should let them practice their craft, not ask them to settle petty feuds and barter for grain. Our master wasted half his life that way. I wasn't about to let that happen to me.
So you wasted half of mine instead?
You're what Dravosht needed. Under me and my precious ideals, this place wouldn't have lasted a year.
So I left to devote myself to the work and spare you lot the consequences. I may be a selfish prick, but I only did what I felt I had to.
What you had to do was your duty!
Even if it meant we all starved?
Enough. This is no time for bickering. You can finish beating each other up once Dravosht is safe.
Fine. I've said my piece anyway.
Yeah. So have I.
Sorry, Clive. I shouldn't have stuck my nose in. We're short enough on time as it is. Still, give us a mo, would you? I need to get my head straight before any of them Akashic try to bite it off.
Prick or not, I won't abandon Dravosht to a swarm of Akashic.
Just say the word. The villagers know to keep out of sight when the fighting starts.
Ready for the off, then?
We can't afford to waste any more time.
Right you are. Might be worth having one last word with the scouts, though. Don't want any nasty surprises, do we? Oh, and Blackthorn, you and Zoltan might be better off staying inside the...
Akashic on the move.
How close are they?
Within sight of the walls, and there are more coming up from the mines.
What was I saying about nasty surprises?
They'll wash right over us if we stay out in the open. We're pulling back behind the gates.
Good idea. Get yourselves inside, but keep your weapons handy.
Understood.
I'm prepared to fight if I have to.
Well, let's hope you don't. That's our job. Once the scouts are inside, order your men to barricade the gates. No heroic last stands, you hear me? No fighting at all if you can help it.
August's right. I've seen what Akashic beasts can do to armor. The people here are tough and willing, but they ain't equipped to face what's coming.
I'm going out there. Start work on the gate as soon as I've left. I'll give you as much time as I can.
And if they kill you?
You evacuate. But it won't come to that. I promise.
You'd better be right.
Take good care of Dravosht till I get back.
Leave it to me. And give those things what for, yeah?
Over here!
this one.
Awaken!
the question is, did I miss any?
Man alive! You're still in one piece!
I slew as many as I could.
As many as I could, he says. The old bleeding lot, more like it. Well, almost.
Only almost.
Yeah, one or two did try to sneak over the wall. But we got the bastards, don't you worry.
Good. Though you do know, more will come in time.
In time, yeah. But we can think about them later. Let's get you back inside.
The beast was charging at me, and he threw himself in its path. He died to save me.
No, he didn't. He's just out cold. He'll be fine when he wakes up.
Thank you for your help, Sid. I don't know if we could have done it without you. But we did, and with hardly a man wounded. Which is well, for we'll be needing all the strength we can to keep the Akashic down.
Sid! You're even more fearsome than your reputation. Enough to give those Akashic monsters nightmares. I almost felt sorry for the wretched things. But mostly, I felt grateful. Dravost won't forget what you did today.
I'm afraid I've only delayed the inevitable. There's no getting rid of that ether flood. Meaning that any living thing which stumbles into those mines will end up clawing at your walls again.
And that's if the flood don't spread. If it does, well, I hate to say it, but the village's days are numbered.
That may be, but we're staying just the same. With the ether floods springing up all over, it's no less safe than anywhere, and more importantly, it's our home. We'll fortify the gates to the north, and I'll see that they're guarded day and night.
All right. Then we'll give you a hand shoring up those defenses.
As for you, Blackthorn, that's twice you've turned up when Dravosh needed you. So, thanks.
I shouldn't have stayed away so long. And I shouldn't have left without talking it over with you first.
Too bloody right you shouldn't. Though I doubt I'd have listened. I always envied you. How you made everything look so easy when, for me, it was anything but. You leaving gave me the perfect excuse to hate you. And from that day on, I never once stopped to wonder what it would have been like if you'd stayed. But what you said earlier, it was true. You'd have been the death of this place.
Finally, something we can agree on. I hope you see the sense of it eventually. You kept this place alive.
Alive, perhaps. Wealthy, even, but Dravosh isn't what it once was. Our work used to be the pride of Dalmechia. Now, we churn out the same rubbish day after day, because it's easy and turns a profit. It's not about the craft anymore. I wouldn't send my sons to war wearing the shit most of our smiths are making. I've kept working, honing my skills, trying to lead by example, but no one sees the point. The average castle apprentice has as much passion for the craft as our current lot. Come back to us, Blackthorn. Remind Dravosht what a true master blacksmith looks like. I'll even man those bellows of yours if it means we can work at the same forge again.
That's a kind offer. Kinder than I deserve. And I wish I could accept, but I'm needed elsewhere. There's people who trust their lives to my steel. And I daren't let him down.
Fair enough.
but that doesn't mean I couldn't visit from time to time. Let's see if we can't rekindle this town's passion for the craft, shall we?
I'd like that.
Just be sure to tell Snotty to let me in the next time I come calling, yeah?
Knowing him, he'd let you in anyway. Blackthorn. The Master Smith turned outlaw, back in my good graces. I never thought I'd see the day.
I'd say that went pretty well, wouldn't you?
Even better than I'd hoped.
Sid, I've got something for you.
And this is?
A token of our lasting gratitude. But I'm of a mind to make you a far grander gift. Designs for a certain sword have been passed down from chief to chief for generations.
Now hold on, Zoltan. There's a reason no one's made that blade in centuries. There's not been a craftsman equal to the task. I'll admit your cinders make impressive steel, and I've learned to hone an edge Odin would be proud of. But the engravings on that thing are enough to make a jeweler cry. And they're not just for show, either.
Have you forgotten what brought you back to Dravosht in the first place? A certain ring? I knew I'd never surpass you with the hammer and tongs. So I turned my hand to a different kind of metalwork between the two of us. I'd say we're the equal of any master craftsman ever to have graced a forge.
You know what? I think you might be right. Clive, you wouldn't mind if Zoltan came back to the Hideaway, would you?
He's more than welcome. As long as he can keep our secret.
Right. Zoltan, get your tools. We've got a legend to forge.
With a little help from Blackthorn, I don't see why we can't restore Dravosht to its former glory. Barring ether floods, that is.
I'll get him back to the Hideaway. Don't you worry about that.
I'll tell you what, Clive. If we pull this off, it will ruin every other sword you've ever held.
Are you hurt?
Just a few cuts and bruises. Nothing worth worrying about.
Can we come out now?
You and your friends saved Dravosht twice over. We'll try not to ask it of you a third time. The flood's still pressing up against our gates. But we've got men, we've got metal, and we've got the will to defend what's ours.
Good girl. Deserve a rest.
Ugh.
one to go.
The bearer of the burning quill is within, my lord. Prithee enter.
Blessings of the Phoenix be upon you, Lord Rosfield. I too serve his grace, albeit in the role of a humble tanner. Tabor's leather is famed throughout the realm. My task is to see that the craft thrives, and the village with it, in order that my brothers and sisters might remain well guarded and fed.
Beneath the flood, yes. And not a stone's throw away.
Oh dear, I hope it doesn't spread.
How are those new boots treating you?
They're fantastic. If the people of Tabor had not built those domes above the stones to protect them from the elements...
That mark... You must be Lord Rosfield. Pleasure to make your acquaintance, my lord. I, too, am a member of the cause, though I spend most of my time hunting. For the good of the village, you understand. The soil is poor here, so the people sup mostly on meat and blood. The hides, meanwhile, they make into leather, and then into gill.
Thank you for the deer leg, mister. Mummy made the pottage for me.
Have you noticed the Elder has been coughing less of late?
Yes. I hear Master Cyril drew up a new tonic for him.
Oh, and a scratch on them. These hides will fetch a good price.
You wouldn't happen to have a decent whetstone in there, would you, madam?
I'm sure I can find you something. All of these stones have a good bit of diamond dust in them. That'll see your sword sharp, all right.
This is the Requietary, an archive where we of the Undying collect and collate our findings. Fragments of Ultima's true nature surely lie buried within these pages. We have only to unearth them.
You have my thanks. Without your medicines and your wisdom, Tabor would be but a shadow of itself.
It is the least we can do in return for your generous hospitality, my lord.
The Undying are not the only secret fellowship in this realm, you know. There are others, each working for their own ends. Why, not so very long ago, a society committed to discovering how one might cast magics without a catalyst was found to be operating throughout Valisthea. They were denounced as heretics, rooted out, and driven from our shores, never to be seen again.
The scraps you are after.
Thanks. Can't do without leather if I'm to polish these stones.
You can go inside if you want, but stay quiet.
Yeah, they're polishing the stones for shipment. Any sudden noises and they might drop one.
These aren't ready for sale, if that's what you're thinking. And I'll thank you to keep your hands to yourself.
The greater number of our order live among the masses, hidden in plain sight. Even here in Tabor, our brothers and sisters pose as common folk. If any should reveal themselves to you, I beg you keep their true identity secret.
Lord Rosfield, is there aught the Undying might assist you with this day?
Perhaps.
My brother said that your order was helping him with his quest to uncover Ultima's origins. Have you learned anything of note since last we spoke?
Little and less, I regret to report.
I see.
Be assured, however, that we will not rest until the truth is known. Even now, our archaeologians scour ruins in every corner of the realm for traces of Ultima's touch.
Fallen ruins, I take it. Dating back as far as Phoenix Gate.
Indeed. Ultima's thralls are oft sighted among the remnants of the fallen civilization, as if protecting the secrets concealed within.
Secrets we'd see unearthed.
Should our methods be of interest, my lord, mayhap it would please you to observe some of our number at work.
Would that be possible?
Of course. A survey has been conducted not far from here. Perchance you are familiar with Kretov, a small hamlet built around a fallen airship. I was due to visit my colleagues there to collect their preliminary findings, but if you would consent to do so in my stead, I'm sure that they would be honored to relate any discoveries they have made to you directly.
All right. I'll go and meet with them.
They will be most gratified, I am sure. Might I suggest you take the road through Titan's Wake? It will lead you straight to the village after but a short walk.
Thank you. I will.
I wish you a safe journey, my lord. May the Firebird's flames burn ever in your heart. My colleagues await you in Kretov, my lord. But say the word, and they will be only too glad to share their findings.
Good girl.
Safe.
Thank you. Oh no. You'll pay for this. Should have stayed in the past. These must be Cyril's colleagues.
You have our thanks, stranger.
Who are you?
Ah, forgive me, my lord. I did not recognize you. You are Lord Rosfield, are you not? We are archaeologians tasked with surveying this site. When the echoes appeared, our brothers here occupied their attentions. Thanks to them, and to you, we were, for a mercy, able to see our duty to its conclusion.
You call that a mercy? Your brothers might still be alive if you put their safety before your duty. Surely this survey wasn't worth dying for.
We are charged with uncovering Ultima's origins. A duty of the highest import, as I'm sure you will agree.
And you think your dead brothers would agree with you too?
I know they would. They gave their lives for the cause, an honor to which all Undying aspire. Now, to what do we owe the honor of your presence, Lord Marquis?
Cyril told me of your work here, and I agree to collect your findings in his stead.
I see. That is most kind. Pray, take them then, with our humble thanks. May the Firebird's flame burn ever in your heart, as it does in ours.
It's one thing to lay down your life for another, but for a survey, I suppose I'd better get this back to Cyril.
Think no more of us, my lord. Only deliver our findings to the bearer of the burning quill.
Let us continue then. There is a second hull further in.
I shall prepare the parchment.
That's better.
The Dominion's here all done for.
And
that's
it's lucky we stayed here. Before you ask, it's all salted. If you want fresher, go find yourself a
one. Haven't seen any of those blue devils, have you? Captain says they might be lurking anywhere.
Fight.
That's all of them. Owain can uncross his toes now.
Ah, you are returned, my lord.
I collected your colleague's preliminary findings. Here, take them.
My thanks. I shall study them, and inform you forthwith if I discover aught that might aid you in your fight against Ultima.
Cyril, your survey party suffered several losses in Kretov. Losses which could have been avoided, had the others not chosen to complete their work instead of saving their friends. Were these your orders?
No. This was their choice. Every Undying devotes his life to the service of the Phoenix. It is our sole duty, and should we die in discharging it, so be it.
Even when death is avoidable.
My lord, I fear that this is not a point over which it would be fruitful to argue. The Undying have served the Phoenix for countless generations, and your opinion of our methods, however earnest, is not like to change them. We live to serve the Phoenix. Our very order exists for that purpose, and that purpose alone.
Cyril, I know that you and your brethren answer only to Joshua, but allow me to offer you a word of advice. It does not further the cause of the Phoenix to have his loyal followers surrender their lives without good reason. Provide your survey parties with an escort, that they might live to do their duty for years to come. Think not only of how you can serve the Phoenix, but how Joshua would want you to serve him. Please. For all our sakes.
I thank you for your advice, my lord. If you will permit me to respond, our faith in his grace, Joshua Rossfield, is absolute. And we of the Undying will do what we believe is right to fulfill our duty unto him. As first shield to the Phoenix, I am sure you understand what it means to do one's duty.
I do.
Then we are of the same mind. And it is my hope that we may continue to do our duty together.
The bearer of the burning quill is within my...
We of the Undying devote our lives to the service of the Phoenix. And you, my lord, are his sworn shield. Sworn to protect him from any danger. We both have our duties. So let us see them done.
Oh. come back.
Ah, the man himself. We were just about to make a start on that sword I promised you. It's funny, but none of this would have been possible without your help. You remember Camille? We'll be using his leather work for the grip. The steel, meanwhile, will be tempered in a fire burning the cinders you charmed out of old Zoltan here. And that whetstone from the Outer Isles? That'll be what gives the blade its edge. And the final flourish will be my talented colleague's engraving.
A team effort led by the greatest blacksmith alive.
Now, save that talk till the thing's finished, yeah? Right. I'm ready if you are.
To the bellows it is, then.
Well, bugger me. We actually did it.
The sword to end all swords. Ragnarok.
It's quite something.
I trust you'll take good care of it.
Thank you. Both of you.
So, does this make you pair the greatest craftsman alive, then?
This? Nah. This was just following the footsteps of the greats of old. It'll take more than that to earn us our place in history. But we're up for the challenge. Here.
A list of materials.
Zoltan and I got talking on the long road back from Dravosht.
We reckon with those items there, we could craft something even better than the Ragnarok. Something worthy of a legendary outlaw like yourself.
That's a weapon I'd like to see. You leave this list with me.
I was hoping you'd say that.
One legend at a time, eh, lads? Before you start on the next, who fancies raising a cup to Friendship Reforged?
Good idea. No more drinking to forget my past. It's about time I had something to celebrate.
Then tap the kegs! Vulcan's boys are on their way!
Trouble with your gear, or... Yeah. The weight of all that shit. Clever girl, that one. I never thought me and Zoltan would ever speak again, let alone work together. And if it hadn't been for you, we wouldn't. You've been a good friend of me, Clive. The best. So, what'll it be? offer.
No need to thank me for the sword. I'm happy just to be here. You've built a fine home for yourselves, and I can see why Blackthorn's so taken with it. Look after the old bastard for me, will you? I'll be off soon, but next time you're in Dalmec here, be sure to pay me a visit. Snotty'll let you in.
Do you reckon we finally got to the bottom of Blackthorn's troubles, then? That'd be something, eh? No, he wouldn't be Blackthorn if he didn't give us the odd scowl.
Run out of Papio nuts and all.
What do you expect?
Still alive, are you? Go on, then. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better all be here. Finished, are you?
Molly's lemon tarts.
Canva lost.
It can't be true.
Miss, can we read Miss Editor's story for our lesson today? How was she? The Enterprise.
Sid, wasn't expecting you back so soon. So, is it good news or bad?
Good, thankfully. Here.
That's brilliant! Thanks a blimmin' million! I'll fit him to the smelter right away! I present to you the Telemon Furnace! Ain't bad, is she?
She's a beauty.
You saved my bacon again, Sid, and I ain't about to let your good deed go unrewarded.
It's fine, really. My bag's flexible enough already.
Oh, don't say that. I'm sure I can make a few improvements to it yet.
You could just buy me a bigger...
How about that clasp? Looks a bit stiff. Reckon you could loosen it up and make some more room? And I reckon I know how. With a new alloy we've been working on, the Telemon Furnace was just what we needed to perfect it. It's a metal, see? So it's lovely and strong, but it's also, well, stretchy, if you can believe it.
Stretchy metal. Well, if you insist.
That is the spirit. You'll love it, I promise. So, what do you reckon?
It's actually quite ingenious. Thank you, Owain.
Don't mention it. You earned it. And I wanted to get some practice in using that metal anyway. Reckon we'll have all kinds of uses for it around the hideaway. Can't think of any right now, but that's our job, innit? Dreaming up new ways to make life easier around here. Maybe even out there, too. One day, the whole world's gonna know about the inventions you've helped us put together. That bag of yours will be the first of many. You mark my words.
They'll hardly believe their eyes, I'm sure.
then. Let's get back to work. These world-changing inventions ain't gonna invent themselves.
So, she don't need sails,